Finally, there's some better news to report, with conditions starting to ease. But some areas are still at risk as we go to air. All eyes are right now on Gympie, north of the Sunshine Coast, where the rising Mary River is threatening businesses in low-lying areas. In Laidley, west of Brisbane, a massive clean-up is already underway after relentless rain lashed the region. Minor flood warnings remain in place and all beaches are closed across the southeast. But it looks like the Sunshine State has avoided a devastating repeat of the disaster we saw just a few months ago.
Creeping closer and closer, an awfully familiar sight for those in Gympie, at the mercy of the rising Mary River threatening the town and everything around it again.
I don't know what words you can say to the businesses that are going to be impacted that would actually ease their pain.
Everyone's
on edge.
On edge.
It's deja vu for devastated business owners. Jodie Field and Daryl Black have faced and overcame this in February. At risk of another major inundation, they're understandably fearing the worst.
And it's just devastating. It's so sad to see. Even now, it's like we moved all the cars, and even though we think it's not going to come through, but you still have a plan.
Today, there was no way in or out of Gympie. Roads are cut, fields flooded, and while water has already washed through some low-lying shop fronts in the CBD, the river is expected to peak at 16 metres, meaning most should avoid severe devastation.
There are four homes that are at risk at 16 metres, so our hope is that, you know, it doesn't reach that height and those homes won't be inundated again.
Overnight, close to 150 millimetres of rain smashed the southeast. Swiftwater rescue crews responded to 14 calls for help. They remain on standby, but the good news is there's reprieve on the way.
Weather conditions are easing, but that does not mean yet that all communities are out of the woods yet.
West of Brisbane, the damage has been done. In Warwick, flooding is widespread. While the enormous clean-up in flood-ravaged Laidley in Queensland's Lockyer Valley is well and truly underway, how long it will take is anyone's guess.
We'll be going for weeks, if not months. You know, there's always going to be mud seeping out of somewhere. It is what it is. You know, as long as you've got 2 feet in a heartbeat, you know, you'll be all right.
Letitia Dean saved what she could. The reality is her business has been hit hard.
Up to about $15,000 worth of stock, just because you can't resell it, you can't move it on.
Despite the despair of the damage, the community and families facing uncertainty are banding together.
It is what it is. We just all get in and clean up and, yeah, go again, eh?
The reality is the hard days are ahead of us. It's that recovery and getting people back into their homes.
As many begin to add up their losses, others are counting their blessings. Overwhelmed and relieved, history hasn't repeated itself. Jacob Chico for 10 News First.
While the worst of the severe weather appears to have passed, several warnings do remain in place. And Samantha Butler is live at Jindalee in Brisbane. Sam, what's the message from authorities this evening?
Well, Charlotte, the message for residents is really to remain vigilant. It's certainly not time to relax just yet. There are still several moderate to major flood warnings in place across a large part of Queensland, as well as minor flood warnings in place for areas such as the Brisbane River behind us here this evening. Over the past couple of days, we've seen an incredible amount of rainfall, with some regions recording five times their May average. But while those heavy falls are starting to ease, catchments are simply saturated, which means that flash flooding remains a very real risk for the southeast and further inland. Across the state, more than 560 roads remain cut. But in some good news today, the Warrego Highway reopened between Toowoomba and Brisbane. But for communities hit hardest by this disaster, the recovery is going to be a very lengthy process. Disaster assistance payments are now available to help individuals impacted cover those immediate costs of things like food, temporary accommodation and clothing. And on top of that, the ADF is also offering helping hands as the cleanup begins. Charlotte?
They'll certainly need it. Thanks for the update, Sam.